Greetings. As Associate Dean for Admissions and Student Affairs at the Ohio University Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine, it's my privilege to convene the 2022 Convocation Ceremony. I extend a hearty welcome to the class of 2026, including class members from Heritage College campuses in Athens, Cleveland, and Dublin. I'd also like to welcome all the family members and friends and distinguished guests with us today. Joining me on the platform are many esteemed individuals who are here to welcome you to the Ohio University, to the college, and to the osteopathic medical profession. Platform party members, if you would please stand as I identify your group and remain standing. Audience members, please hold your applause until all guests have been introduced. I'm honored to welcome representatives of the Ohio University Board of Trustees, representatives from the Heritage College's Society of Alumni and Friends and our Student Government Association, representatives of the Osteopathic Heritage Foundation and the Ohio Osteopathic Association, academic and administrative leaders and faculty members from the university and the college. Many other faculty and staff members are also here to extend their welcome and best wishes to you, including those based in Athens, Cleveland, and Dublin, as well as faculty and staff from our clinical training sites throughout the state, who will play a critical role in your education in your third and fourth years. It's now my pleasure to introduce the Heritage College's Executive Dean and Ohio University's Chief Medical Affairs Officer, Dr. Ken Johnson.
Thanks, John. Yeah. Appreciate it. Well, welcome, students, honored guests, and thank you, Dr. Schreiner. So I have a bit of an inside joke going with the class here, and I have to say that this afternoon is going to be beyond wicked awesome. It's extraordinary to see so many family members, friends, loved ones, both here in Athens and those joining us online, as we welcome the newest class of medical students to Ohio University. Convocation is one of the most important ceremonies that we have. Our other one is commencement, so in some ways this is the bookend of your journey with us. It's a chance to welcome the newest members to the osteopathic community. During the ceremony, we will present each student with their own white coat, marking the transition into the study of osteopathic medicine. We will also award the Phillips Medal of Public Service. This is the college's highest honor. Class of 2026, the timing of your entry into medical school is notable. Society is still grappling with the impacts of a global pandemic. Current events have underscored the incredible importance of the profession that you have chosen. Compassionate, patient-focused physicians are needed now more than ever. Rest assured that the Heritage College will prepare you to lead and succeed, and more than succeed, in today's rapidly changing healthcare environment. The premise of our Pathways to Health and Wellness curriculum is that learning environments should mirror modern healthcare. You'll learn to work as part of a team, much like physicians do today, to advocate for your patients to improve their health, all while maintaining a much-needed focus on your own wellness. Our faculty and staff had poured their hearts and souls into our curriculum in its design and its delivery. I couldn't be prouder of their efforts and their willingness to join us as members of the Heritage College. I couldn't be prouder of their efforts and your willingness to join as members of the Heritage College class of 2026. You are going to help make the Heritage College totally wicked awesome. Since our college was founded, we have recruited students with a strong sense of altruism, compassion, as well as strong academic performance, and this year's class is no exception. So many of you are here today, 92% in fact, are from Ohio. I am incredibly proud of that figure as we work to ensure that the citizens in all parts of our state have the health care that they need. We're also committed to recruiting a diverse student population, and I'm proud of our efforts there as well. This year, 28% of our incoming students are members of minority groups, and 18% are the first in their family to go to college, not medical school, college. Students, regardless of who you are or where you're from, you were selected because of your potential to be truly outstanding osteopathic physicians. We're so looking forward to the great things that you will do. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Hugh Sherman, President of Ohio University. Dr. Sherman.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson. During a time when we're reminded so frequently about the importance of the healthcare providers play in our communities and around the world, I'm extremely proud to be here today with so many future physicians and their loved ones. Students, no matter whether you are studying on our Athens campus, our Cleveland campus, or our Dublin campus, I welcome you today as members of the Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine and the Ohio University family. Established in 1804, Ohio University is Ohio's first university, but it wasn't until 1976 that we welcomed our first class of medical students. Today, our graduates are leaders in every field of medicine. Our college provides an important access to healthcare in communities in Ohio and around the world where it's needed most. Our research programs address some of the most pervasive health issues, and our research discoveries are helping physicians treat patients and save lives. You will see that the college's mission of education, research, and service is built on a firm foundation led by outstanding faculty members. By enrolling in the Heritage College, you've taken on a great responsibility, not just for yourself, but also for this college. You are the future of this world-class medical school. Through the fulfillment of your individual promise, we will collectively fulfill our promise to improve the human condition. And just as you've taken on this great responsibility, we take our responsibility to you very seriously. The faculty and staff of Ohio University are committed to providing you with the nation's best transformational learning experience. Your faculty members will encourage and cultivate your talents and expertise. You will work side by side with researchers on projects that will advance the means to better diagnose, treat, and cure patients. I encourage you to make the most of these learning experiences every step of the way. Your time at Ohio University is not simply a means to an end. All along the journey, you will change and improve lives, including your own. When you graduate, you will join a distinguished family of alumni among the ranks of the world's brightest, most caring, most compassionate physicians and surgeons. We are very proud that you've chosen to join the Bobcat family. Welcome to you all.
Thank you, Dr. Sherman. We now convene the awarding of the Phillips Medal of Public Service. This award was first bestowed in 1976 by the Ohio University, what was then the Ohio University College of Osteopathic Medicine, which is now known as Ohio University's Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine, and it remains the college's highest honor. The Phillips Medal of Public Service is named for the late J. Wallace and Jody Galbraith Phillips to recognize their contributions of a couple who did so much for Ohio University, for higher ed, and for the people of Ohio. I'm honored to present this year's Phillips Medal to the late Dr. Anthony Chila, or who more affectionately would like to be called Tony, an incredible practitioner and a world-class educator who served the Heritage College from 1978 until his retirement in 2011. Dr. Chila is a true legend in osteopathic medicine, whose research and scholarship have influenced students and physicians around the globe. His patients in our OMM clinic, which used to be affiliated with the college, continually sang his praises. But he's best known to the Ohio University community as a passionate and beloved medical educator. I had the incredible opportunity to learn from Dr. Chila starting in 1989 as a student at the University of New England. And I can personally attest to his masterful teaching, which transformed my patient care. I'm honored that a physician of such distinction played such a pivotal role in many of the lives of our Heritage College students. Who better to explain the impact of Dr. Chila than his own students and understudies? So at this time, I'll ask you to turn your attention to the screen behind me.
Dr. Chila had a really big impact on the field of osteopathic medicine as a whole, as an author of a major textbook that's used at almost all medical schools currently. He's taught in the classroom at the Heritage College. He taught in the clinical setting with students in his classrooms and to his patients throughout the years. The amount of time he spent at the college as a whole means he's touched most of the graduates from our college in some capacity over the course of those years.
You know, I was a student here myself and started in 88. And I don't think we as students really knew what a gem we had here. You know, he was internationally known, he taught, he wrote books. He's so, you know, he's who I think of when I think of osteopathic medicine.
He's very well respected across the countries. And to give an idea like how much he taught overseas as well as here, one time when I house sat one year, he went to 14 different countries.
But there was one thing that Tony kept repeating to me, especially the first couple years I was working with him, and that was he would always tell me, Sean, you have to get yourself out of the way. And I can't really say I understood exactly what that meant during that first year, but as time has gone on, I think I've gotten to understand everything that meant. And it's got multiple layers to it. And I can still hear him saying that to me when I'm working with a patient or working with a student, helping them learn. And my mind starts to wander. I'm very intently trying to get through something. And I realize that I am, again, in my own way. And I can still hear him over my shoulder saying that.
I think that for students who enter an osteopathic family and the profession of osteopathic medicine, it's important to know that physicians like Dr. Chila may be very unique in their perspective and their skill sets, but that their knowledge and expertise has been transmitted to so many of us in the community, and that it's our job, both as educators, as students, and as future physicians, to embrace some of the theories that were learned and taught through those skill sets as they move forward in your career.
Be where you're at when you're there. And that was a very important saying for him. I think he would say, you're an osteopathic physician, so those principles we teach you should be thought of and experienced by every single patient.
He really wanted to make sure that whoever was talking to you in your role as a physician, whether it was a student, a teacher, or a patient, that you were entirely there, that you were present, and that you were receiving what was being given to you.
I actually wrote a inspirational phrase or phrase down one time thinking about Dr. Chila. I'd like to share this with the students if that's okay. For everyone we teach, the lives they touch are touched by us. Every life they save, a family has their loved ones longer. For everyone we mentor, a legacy begins. A legacy that spans three generations is how we live forever. And Dr. Chila will live forever.
Thank you for that. President Sherman will now read the Phillips Medal citation, which is displayed to my right. Following the reading, Dr. Jean Reddos will accept the medal on behalf of Dr. Chila's family. Dr. Reddos serves as an associate clinical professor of OMM here at the college.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson. The citation reads, in honor of exemplary patient care, masterful teaching, innovative research, and notable contributions to the advancement of osteopathic manipulative medicine, we are pleased to present Dr. Anthony Chila with the Phillips Medal of Public Service. As a passionate and beloved medical educator, Dr. Chila made an indelible mark on the lives and careers of countless Heritage College graduates. as well as medical students and physicians across the globe over the course of his 50-plus year career. As a leading authority on osteopathic manipulative medicine, Dr. Chila's clinical research has been extensively featured in the American Osteopathic Association research conferences and congresses of the International Federation of Manual Medicine, in addition to numerous publications. His passion for scientific discovery lives on through his many mentees, whom Dr. Chila worked tirelessly to develop. Throughout varied university service, including Chief of Clinical Research and Chair of the Department of Family Medicine, Dr. Chila's exemplary leadership served to advance Ohio University and his College of Osteopathic Medicine. His enduring legacy as a masterful practitioner and a world-class educator remains a source of immense pride and distinction for the entire Heritage College community. Dr. Chila's accolades include the American Osteopathic Foundation's Educator of the Year Award, the Gluten-Sun Denslow Award from the American Osteopathic Association's Bureau of Research, and the American Academy of Osteopathic Andrew Taylor Still Medallion of Honor, among many others. Today, the Heritage College is proud to add to that list as we honor Dr. Chila with our 2022 Phillips Medal of Public Service. Dr. Ritos, will you please come forward?
I can say a few words. This is awesome. Welcome. It is quite an opportunity and honor to be here to accept this award on behalf of Dr. Chila and his family, his wife Helen, his daughter Anne, his son-in-law Matt, and granddaughters Sarah and Kate. Dr. Chila is, as you can see by the video, touched a lot of people. And I was honored enough to be his nurse, his student, his resident, his colleague, his physician, but most of all, his friend. I really think that if he's standing here today, what he would say to you is, don't forget what an opportunity we have to be osteopathic physicians. So many people in the world do not get this opportunity, and you can touch so many lives. The other thing that I think was really obvious to me when I first met Dr. Chila is that you would not know when he walked in a room and out of a room, if that person was living on the streets or if it was the president of Ohio University. Just saying. He treated everybody the same. He was an amazing practitioner, always thinking. He will be missed, but in a way, he won't be missed because he'll be remembered. So what I would challenge you today with is that find a mentor. Be open, he was my mentor, be open to what they have to say, good, bad, the ugly about you, what comments they give you. Be open to asking questions. We can't all know everything. Don't pretend you know what you don't know, and be where you're at when you're there. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Ritos. As a former student of Dr. Chila's, I'm delighted that the college has chosen to honor his legacy in this way. I'm Dr. Tracy Schaub, the interim Athens Dean at the Heritage College in Athens campus. And it's my pleasure to welcome the class of 2026 and their guests to Athens. It's at this point in the ceremony that we bestow a time-honored symbol of the medical profession, the white coat, on our newest class of students. The short white coat represents the student physician in training. After graduation, each new physician will have earned the right to wear a long white coat. Most of us would agree that the white coat has come to signify the trust that people place in us and the great responsibility that trust entails. While learning scientific method and applying it to medical decisions is critical preparation for all physicians, the development of a standard of professionalism, compassion, and respect for the public trust is equally important. William Osler, MD, made his mark at the turn of the 20th century and is widely known as the father of American medicine. In his essay entitled The Student Life, he writes, "The art of detachment, the virtue of method, and the quality of thoroughness may make you students, in the true sense of the word, successful practitioners or even great investigators, but your characters may still lack that which can alone give permanence to power, the grace of humility. We invite you to accept this white coat as a cloak of compassion and humility to guide your lives as physicians. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Bill Burke, Dean of the Heritage College, Dublin."
Thank you very much, Dr. Schaub. As an alumnus, I can clearly remember being in your shoes. The relief that comes with being accepted into medical school, the excitement to begin my medical training, and a bit of initial uncertainty or trepidation. Am I really ready for this? As a Heritage College graduate, I can assure you that you made the right choice. The education and opportunities experienced during my time as a student at the Heritage College set a firm foundation which propelled me on a remarkable journey as an osteopathic physician. You know, students, as you receive your white coats today, please remember, you know, that being an osteopathic physician is a great privilege. You now represent not only yourselves, but your college and your profession as well. Although I won't promise you that your journey will always be easy, mine certainly was not. I can assure you that everyone at the Heritage College will do everything we can to help you be the absolute best physicians you can be. It is now my pleasure to introduce Molly Frey, our Student Government Association President at the Heritage College Dublin, who will be speaking today on behalf of our three SGA presidents. Osteopathic medical student Frey earned a Bachelor of Science degree in biology with minors in chemistry and psychology from my alma mater, Capital University. She is now a second year student on our Dublin campus. Osteopathic medical student Frey.
Thank you, Dr. Burke. On behalf of the Heritage College Student Government Association, I'm honored to welcome all of the family, friends, and loved ones who are in the audience today. But most importantly, I would like to welcome our guests of honor, the Heritage College Class of 2026. You all have finished undoubtedly difficult degrees prior to your start here, and now have successfully matriculated at the Heritage College. You are currently living in the moment of what once seemed an intangible goal. I cannot emphasize enough how quickly the next year will fly by. It seems like only yesterday I was sitting in the same seats you are now, excited for what the future holds and ready to celebrate a special day with the support system that helped to make my dream a reality. Today marks a truly momentous occasion in your lives. Once you receive your white coat, you no longer represent just yourself, but the entirety of the osteopathic profession. The white coat represents professionalism, integrity, compassion, and most importantly, a lifelong commitment to help those in need. Your white coat will change people's perspective of you. Every time you walk into a patient's room, you will bring with you every moment, every memory that patient has of their interactions within the medical system. It is your responsibility to use the reverence that accompanies wearing a white coat to positively impact the lives of each and every person you care for. The majority of the time that you wear your HCOM white coat will be filled with countless possibilities and excitement, a chance to sharpen your skills. However, there will also be times when you see patients at the most vulnerable time in their lives. Therefore, treat every patient you encounter with the utmost respect and dignity. Your patients will look to you for advice and knowledge, but always be mindful of what you can learn from your patients. And always remember, before patients care to hear how much you know, they want to hear how much you care. I believe if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. The journey to becoming an osteopathic physician is a trying one, but there's nothing more osteopathic than family. Look around this room at the people sitting next to you, those who you may know, others you may not. Over the next 4 years and beyond, these people will become your family. They will lift you up when the going gets tough and push you to be the best version of yourself. I urge you to work together, support one another, walk in humility, and engage in the parts of life that bring you joy and resiliency. I'm excited for what the future holds for all of you. Congratulations, class of 2026, and welcome to the Heritage College family. I'd now like to introduce Dr. Isaac Kirstein, Dean of the Heritage College, Cleveland.
Thank you, osteopathic medical student Frey. As Dean of the Heritage College's Cleveland campus, I'd like to extend a personal welcome to the class of 2026. It is hard to believe it's been 7 years since I welcomed the first class of students at the Heritage College Cleveland. I stand here today as an equally proud dean welcoming students from all three campuses as members of our class of 2026. I'm awestruck when I reflect upon how far our college has come over the last few years, and I can't wait to see what the future holds in store for all of us. Each of our three Heritage College campuses has a unique personality and has a different feel. But whether you're part of the Cleveland campus, the Dublin campus, or the Athens campus, we challenge you to work together and remember that you are all part of the same class, the Heritage College class of 2026. No matter which campus you're studying on, you'll be an integral part of our success, and we encourage you to share your ideas for making this college a better place for all of our students in all locations throughout the duration of your training. At this time, I'd like to introduce Dr. Jennifer Gwillem, president of the Ohio Osteopathic Association and a 2003 Heritage College graduate. Dr. Gwillem is a respected physician and preceptor who has served the college and the osteopathic profession through numerous leadership roles. She is currently serving as commissioner for the American Osteopathic Association's Commission on Osteopathic College Accreditation, and she is the interim chair of the college's Department of Primary Care. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Gwillem.
Thank you, Dr. Kirstein. Welcome, future osteopathic physicians. It is my privilege to be with you here today as the president of the Ohio Osteopathic Association, also known as the OOA, to celebrate the beginning of your medical education. The OOA has a long tradition of providing the white coats that you have today that you will wear for the next 4 years. We are proud that our patch, which is sewn onto your shoulder, will accompany you on your journey and serve to always remind you that the OOA is here to support you. The OOA works to promote the distinctive philosophy and practice of osteopathic medicine in Ohio. Osteopathic physicians have a long and distinguished history of patient care in Ohio, and the OOA is proud to have been advocates for these extraordinary physicians and for the profession in Ohio since 1898. You are the future of osteopathic medicine. We are committed to your success. The OOA is your professional home, and we will be here for you over the next 4 years and beyond, providing legislative advocacy that will protect the value of your medical degree and ensure your role as the leader of the healthcare team. The OOA also connects you to residency programs with osteopathic recognition and provides leadership and networking opportunities. It is through these experiences that you will discover the national leadership role that Ohio plays in the osteopathic profession. We look forward to connecting with you on this journey. We ask that you find us online at our website, ohiodo.gov, as well as on social media. You'll also soon begin receiving our popular weekly emails called OsteoFacts for the latest on all things osteopathic medicine. I wish you well in your studies and hope you wear your white coats with pride and knowledge that we support you on your journey to becoming an osteopathic physician. Again, welcome to the family. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Jody Jerome, Senior Associate Dean for Medical Education and a fellow Heritage College alumna. Dr. Jerome.
Thanks, Dr. Gwillem. I'm delighted to recognize the class of 2026 as we present each student with a white coat, symbolic of the tremendous responsibility that is incumbent on those who seek to enter the healing professions. The individuals who will be joining us on stage to coach students are a very special group. They include family members of students from the class of 2026, as well as physicians from some of our clinical partners. Would all of our coders please stand to be recognized? Thank you. Students, please follow the marshals as they direct you to the stage. You will advance five at a time. Dr. John Schreiner, Associate Dean for Admissions and Student Affairs, and Ms. Jill Harmon, Senior Director for Admission and Recruitment, will be announcing your names along with the acronym OMS. For those of you who are unfamiliar with this term, it stands for Osteopathic Medical Student. Once the entire class has been coded, Dr. John Ramey will lead the students in reciting the Pledge of Commitment.
Firing. Yeah. OMS Anthony Achille. OMS Courtney Ahmed. OMS Ibrahim Alaga. OMS Youssef Alaga. OMS Kaylee Anstead. OMS Joseph Balin. OMS Aaron Batke. OMS Stephen Bell. OMS Ishan Bott. OMS Colton Blankenship. OMS Aiden Bobro. OMS Skyler Boggs. OMS Samuel Borgamenke. Ole Miss, Tyler Bonner. Ole Miss, Tristan Borky Armstrong. Ole Miss, James Brown. Ole Miss, Cole Buchanan. Ole Miss, Maria Burks. Ole Miss, Jose Alejandro Cano Perez. Ole Miss, Matthew Call. Ole Miss, Thaddeus Casaneda. Ole Miss, Suzanne Shar. Ole Miss, Amni Shaban. Ole Miss, Alexander Chang. Ole Miss, Jessica Shebra. Ole Miss, Liz Janagi. Ole Miss, Rebecca Clark. Ole Miss, John Cooney. Ole Miss, Isaiah Komnick. Ole Miss, Grace Counts. Ole Miss, Caitlin Cincinnatus. Ole Miss, Lauren Denny. Ole Miss, Caitlin DeWitt. Ole Miss, Olivia Dillman. Ole Miss, Sean Diamond. Ole Miss, Luke DeSico. Ole Miss, Matthew Dugan. Ole Miss, Asari Ake. Ole Miss, Kyle Durgan. Ole Miss, David Asarco. Ole Miss, Jacob Asarco. Ole Miss, Anya Espa. Sarah Fagmegbe. Ole Miss, Taylor Fannin. Ole Miss, Cheyenne Fincham. Ole Miss Andrew Gerton. Ole Miss Zachary Frank. Ole Miss Alec Fletcher. Ole Miss Brian Gabriel. Ole Miss Danielle Gaddis. Ole Miss Lucy Gideon. Ole Miss Brandy Graham. Ole Miss Caitlin Jacoby. Ole Miss Alexandra Holm. Ole Miss Omar Iskandarani. Ole Miss Finley Coker. Ole Miss Mackenzie Joseph. Ole Miss Allison Johnson. Ole Miss Jessica Jenkins. Ole Miss Kenneth Jenkins. Ole Miss Tony Coons. Ole Miss Suhas Coley. Excuse me. Ole Miss Thomas Kraus. Ole Miss Catherine Colt. Ole Miss Haley Leftwich. Ole Miss Megan Long. Ole Miss Vanya Lunkiel. Ole Miss Anita Mancini. Ole Miss Hannah May. Ole Miss Michael Matten. Ole Miss Sabrina McCarthy. Ole Miss John McCaskey. Ole Miss Elizabeth Milks. Ole Miss Miranda Moore. Ole Miss Josie Myers. Ole Miss Isabel Morse. Ole Miss Danair Newsom. Ole Miss Asal Nasser. Ole Miss Benjamin Obringer. Ole Miss Brianna O'Neill. Omas Jack Palanti. Omas Nadia Punessa. Omas Barika Patuk. Omas Glennis Polly. Omas Abigail Prendergast. Omas Christophros Proko. Omas Catherine Quinn. Omas Olivia Ramsey. Yeah! Omas Connor Randall. Omas Shannon Reardon. OMS Mercedes Reed. OMS Ethan Rivas. OMS Madison Riley. OMS Nathan Rodriguez. OMS Vanessa Rodriguez. OMS Carly Rother. OMS Jasanvir Sunda. OMS Anthony Sansone. OMS Jarrett Shook. OMS Patrick Shetzley. OMS Svetlana Sherobakova. OMS Kyle Simon. OMS Shivani Singh. OMS Brian Soap. OMS Aya Saeed. OMS Marlon Shapontiak. OMS Jordan Tenenbaum. OMS Kiana Ayers. OMS Abrahamda Wako. OMS Jenna Warnemont. OMS Kendall Watson. OMS Simon Weiss. OMS Solomon Weiss. OMS Hunter Welch. OMS Christina Williams. OMS Luke Wesniewski. OMS Haley Wilson. Ole Miss Allie Woosty. Ole Miss Juliana Yates. Ole Miss Lee Yates. Ole Miss Louis Jung. Ole Miss Anthony Zeno. Thank you, doctors.
Ms. Michaela Abumarato. OMS Maria Alamir. OMS Patricia Alley. OMS Miriam Ali. OMS Isaac Ija. OMS William Barrett. OMS Amy Bolus. OMS Brittany Childs. OMS Akiva Elif. OMS Michael Barbie. OMS Jonathan Caldwell. OMS Leah Espinal. OMS Isabella Francisco. OMS Sean Frisbee. OMS Shimon Gore Panter. OMS Amy Franz. OMS Sarah Grinstead. OMS Brandon Jackson. OMS Sweta Caretti. OMS Hannah Harden. OMS Clark Kellum. OMS Brendan Kenahan. OMS Caroline Krutoff. OMS Justina Kubiak. OMS Alexander Lodazinski. OMS Nathan Lippincott. OMS Yulia Lozinska. OMS Emmett Leiden. OMS Matthew Magro. OMS Nina Merrick. OMS Megan McDonald. OMS Casey Merton. OMS Diana Mustafa. OMS Untu Huen Nguyen. OMS Il Woon Park. OMS Nandini Patel. OMS Nina Patel. OMS Destiny Paulin. OMS Kaylee Pollock. OMS Kaylee Quasar. OMS Alyssa Rice. OMS Emma Russ. OMS Tierra Sanders. OMS Kristen Shu. OMS Alexis Scott. OMS Jacqueline Seifring. OMS Mariana Silvestri. OMS Xavier Sonlin. OMS Kenesia Solayova. OMS Dalia Tabachnik. OMS Marissa Tandy. OMS Peter Spencer. OMS Adam Taha. OMS Jack Sparrow. OMS Winston Torres. OMS Caitlin Tortorette. OMS Olivia Vallejo Hanolo. OMS Marissa Visley. OMS Jessica Vitrano. OMS Jack Young. OMS Alcario Williams. OMS Unique Willis Norris. Thank you, doctors. OMS Catherine Alexander. OMS Thapavsi Ananta. OMS Paige Anderson. OMS Mackenzie Atwell. OMS Rachel Brogy. OMS Talia Caridi. OMS Reagan Churley. OMS Reagan Clark. OMS Emily Cushing. OMS Kathleen D'Angelo. OMS Alessandra Derrick. OMS Megan Fleshman. OMS Sydney Fournier. OMS Nikit Gada. OMS Samantha Galifo. OMS Maximilian George. OMS Austin Gerwig. OMS Sonia Gessis. OMS Natalie Holdsworth. OMS Mitchell Hughes. OMS Cindy Nguyen. OMS Sarah Mwali. OMS Sophia Ironton. OMS Finney Johns. OMS Jacob Kotzen. OMS Cameron Kramer. OMS Olivia Coons. OMS Daria Cooperberg. OMS Lillian Lacey. OMS Isla Lahouti. OMS Jackie Luby. OMS Gabriela Lopez. OMS Georgia Mattingly. OMS Vishvam Mehta. OMS Annabella Mershad. OMS Justin Messinger. OMS Addison Miller Brown. OMS Justin Mormal. OMS Zoltan Nemenye. OMS Ellen Narcissian. OMS Gregory Norwood Yost. OMS Akram Osman. OMS Anisha Patel. OMS Jonathan Peters. OMS Kyle Petty. OMS Colin Reeves. OMS Theodore Renner. OMS Gabrielle Romaker. OMS Connor Ross. OMS Brianna Santoso. OMS Katrina Schmidt. OMS Lauren Schnipke. OMS Sam Schoenfeld. OMS Taylor Selby. OMS Nina Szymanski. OMS Nicholas Schenker. OMS Christina Sly. OMS Prosper Sikoyumbaya. OMS Luke Stewart. OMS Nicholas Sulio. OMS Shreyas Sunkum. OMS Gabrielle Thayer. OMS Elizabeth Toygo. OMS Matthew Troyer. OMS Kiriaki Vasil. OMS Hans von Niederhausern. OMS Ian Wyland. Yeah! OMS Adrian Weininger. OMS Calvin Walford. Oh, I'm sorry. OMS Alex Wallett. OMS Juliana Hotmeyer. Thank you, doctors. Unable to attend, but part of the entering class of 2022, OMS Peter Sod.
Woohoo! Now, promise me you're gonna call these students and just yell that at any point in time during the year. They'll still need that energy and support. I am Dr. Tanisha King, and as Chief Inclusion Officer here at the Heritage College, I work to cultivate a community of mutual respect, acceptance, and dialogue related to diversity, equity, and inclusion. On behalf of our faculty and staff, I'd like to be the first to congratulate the class of 2026 on receiving your white coats. In the words of Dr. Johnson, they look wicked awesome. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. John Ramey, who will lead students in the Pledge of Commitment. Dr. Ramey is a 1992 Heritage College graduate who serves as the president of the Ohio University Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine Society of Alumni and Friends Board of Directors. As we like to say here at Ohio University, Dr. Ramey's blood runs green as a two-time graduate of Ohio University. He is a respected physician and a dedicated preceptor with more than 30 years experience in the medical field. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Ramey.
Good afternoon. So you know I'm the last speaker, so you know what that means. We got this. All right. So it is indeed a proud day to be a DO in Ohio, and I want to really give my sincere congratulations to our honored osteopathic medical students. So if you would please join me in reciting the Student Pledge of Commitment. The text of the pledge is found on the card in the breast pocket of your white coat. So please stand and raise your right hand, and please turn and face the audience. And please repeat after me. Raise your right hands. As I proceed down the long path of learning, entering the phase of education at the Ohio University Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine, I commit to lifelong learning. Because I believe that each patient should be treated as a whole person, with the physician serving to facilitate the patient's own natural recovery mechanism. I commit to the philosophy of osteopathic medicine. Because I value the knowledge and achievements of those physicians who have preceded me and those who will become my respected teachers and colleagues. I commit to the osteopathic profession by developing my skills with respect, compassion, and empathy for others, and by valuing cultural differences and diversity. I commit to the delivery of quality health care, to recognize both my weaknesses and my strengths, to strive to enhance those qualities that will inspire confidence and outfit me for skilled, compassionate patient care, and to support and uphold the osteopathic profession and the principles upon which it stands, I do pledge. Congratulations and thank you. So at this time, I would please to turn the podium back over to Dr. Schreiner. Dr. Schreiner.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, Dr. Ramey. I believe that each one of you will find the next 4 years to be both challenging and rewarding. This concludes the ceremonies for the 47th Annual Convocation of the Ohio University Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine. On behalf of the college and university, I wish to thank you for your participation in our convocation and in our educational venture. We ask that you please remain seated as the students file out. Shuttle buses are available to transport guests back to the convocation parking lots. As you're leaving Templeton Blackburn Alumni Memorial Auditorium, you may wish to take photos with Dr. Rufus and our college branding exhibits in the lobby. I also encourage you to follow the college's social media accounts to see a gallery of images taken by our college photographers here today. I now declare this convocation officially adjourned.